The Thunder Lightning edition of the Power Rankings features a two-headed monster on Bourbon Street, a journeyman quarterback making waves and the beginning of the end for America's team. Week 10 Power Rankings 1. Eagles 81 last week won. The well-rested Wentz Wagon returns from their bye to face the Cowboys and Big D on Sunday night. Philly would like nothing better than to embarrass their hated rivals in primetime and basically wrap up the NFC East before Thanksgiving. 2. Patriots 72 last week 3. I cannot believe that a 40-year-old Tom Brady is still the best player in the NFL. It makes no sense whatsoever. The ageless wonder tossed 3 more 2-counts in a rout over Broncos. Next up, the Raiders in Mexico. How do you say Superman in Spanish? 3. Saints 72 last week 5. A team coached by Sean Payton and quarterbacked by Drew Brees has won 7 in a row on the strength of their defense and running game, believe it. The two-headed monster of Mark Ingram and Alvin Kamara is scary good. Some people in the Jets organization wanted Kamara. You think gangrene could have used the game-changing RB Mark 10 Elliott 4? Steelers 72 last week 2. Big Ben Co. actually dropped a couple spots in our coveting rankings despite winning their 4th in a row. Hey, barely beating the Colts isn't something to be bragging about. 5. Rams 72 last week 6. Jared Goff became the first quarterback in franchise history to throw for 300 yards, 3 TDs and no INTs in back-to-back games. Sean McVay turned a lifeless offense into the league's highest scoring outfit. It's amazing. LA's defense has been no slouch either, with only 57 points allowed in the past 5 games. 6. Chiefs 63 last week 7. What better way to come off your bye week than facing a Giants team that has quit on its embattled head coach? My God, Alex Smith might drop a 50 burger on Big Blue. 7. Vikings 72 last week 9. What was cooler, Teddy Bridgewater shedding tears after his long road back from a grievous knee injury, or Case Keenum throwing 4 2-counts? Both are terrific stories for a team that has won 5 in a row. Jeffrey T. Barnsap 8. Seahawks 63 last week 8. We already knew that Seattle couldn't run the ball, but can it survive the loss of Richard Sherman too? I'm starting to have serious doubts. 9. Cowboys 54 last week 4. Dallas tumbles 5 spots after getting roughed up by the Falcons. The bad news, Zeke Elliott isn't coming back for at least another 3 weeks. The good news, left tackle Tyron Smith should be back against the Eagles on Sunday night. 10. Panthers 73 last week 10. Cam Newton sure didn't miss Kelvin Benjamin in Carolina's Monday night laugher over the Dolphins. 11. Falcons 54 last week 14. The reigning NFC champs still don't look quite right, but a laugher over the Cowboys helps them climb 3 spots. Can they win in Seattle on Monday night? If so, I might be a believer again. Jeff Haynes app 12. Jaguars 63 last week 15. Could the Chargers figure out more ways to gag away a game regardless? Amos Alonzo Maroney deserves credit for helping his team win their 3rd straight to remain in a tie atop the AFC South. 13. Lions 54 last week unranked. Matthew Stafford is willing his team to victories. They'll try to make it 3 in a row in Chicago this week. 14. Titans 63 last week 12. Marcus Mariota Co. dropped a couple spots. Despite a late rally to beat the Bengals, mainly because I just don't think they're very good. Sure, Tennessee has won 4 consecutive games, but the last 3 have been by a combined 10 points. 15. Packers 54 last week unranked. Brett Hundley showed some savvy on his game-winning 2-count pass in the waning minutes against Chicago. Let's see if there's a carryover effect against the Ravens. Notes: the Bills and Washington dropped out of the top 15.